you go, Crocky. You'll be back splashing around with your float in no time.
His what now?
His float. That's what you call a group of crocodiles. Animal groups have all kinds of fun names.
Really? Like, what else?
Aha! I'm glad you asked.
Well, geese live in a gaggle and coyotes in a pack, and a group of jellyfishes called a snack. Here's a rookery of seals and an army made of ants. By the seashore you can find a gulf of cormorants, zeal of zebras, hover of crows, lions are prides, as everyone knows. There are quivers of cobras and shivers of sharks, and an exultation is a group of larks.
Wow, she really rehearsed this.
You've got prickles full of porcupines, consortiums of crabs, and a loveliness of ladybugs just looks so fab. A kaleidoscope of butterflies, a scurry full of squirrels, and this float of hippopotami are happy girls. Circus of puffins, geese of raccoons, stand-up flamingos, troop of baboons. A group of bugs becomes a clash, but rhinoceros can make an even bigger crash! Now, here's the one and only Neverbeast!
Neverbeast?
Neverbeast?
Never mind. Tell you later.
So, kangaroos can form a mob, iguanas are a mess, even friendly ravens are an unkindness. Goldfish are a troubling, pandas are embarrassments, but a wise old bunch of owls form a parliament. Shrewdness of apes and mischief of rats, business of ferrets and cauldron of cats. And although his strange credulity, these wildebeests are an impossibility.
What were hippos again?
Disney's Tinkerbell and the Legend of the Neverbeast, coming soon to Blu-ray and digital, rated G.